everyone, welcome back to my online YouTube class. So dear students, today we are going to discuss about the modal helping verbs. Previously we have discussed about the primary auxiliary helping verbs in our previous videos. Now here the second part is modal helping verbs. Today we will discuss about that. Now let's read the following sentences here. I can jump the wall. Could I see your drawing? We must obey our elders. I must help her at all costs. So in English language there are few words, few helping verbs which are used to show the possibility, capability, ability or necessity and advice or suggestion. So these words are considered as modals. Okay, so today we will discuss about these words, and in these examples also I am going to underline these words. I can, then here could, okay, then here we have must, here also must, okay. And apart from these words there are few more like will, then we have would, then ought to, need, okay, then should, and there are few more, but in this book we are going to discuss only three or four. So can, could, must, these are the modal helping verbs. Can, could and must in the above sentences show some kind of power, request or determination. Okay, now let's see here for what purpose they are used. Use of can. Can is used to express the ability or power. Means if we talk about some person's ability, whether he or she is able to perform any task or not. Okay, now let's read the examples. I can do this work means I have the ability or capability that I can do this work. I have that power, I can do this work. I can carry this heavy box means I am capable of carrying this heavy box. I have that much power. Okay, so can. I can jump from the top. Can. I have that ability. I can finish my food. I have that ability to finish my food. Okay, so can basically shows us ability or power. Can also be used to show the possibility. Okay, then here can is used to take or give permission when we want somebody to allow us to do something, to seek permission. Okay, now example, can I leave my books here? So I am asking for the permission of someone to leave my books there. You can go now. Here in this sentence we are granting permission, means we are allowing someone to go, so we are giving the permission. You can go now, then we can use can here. So here it is to take permission, to grant permission. Okay, grant means to give permission, to allow someone. Then third use of can is used to express the possibility, means how much chances are there of something to happen. Now कितनी possibility है कि ये चीज़ हो सकती है, ठीक है. Example, he can be a robber. There is a possibility that he can become a robber. We can go there tomorrow means there are chances that we can go there tomorrow. Okay, so I hope the use of can is clear to you. Now use of could. Okay, so could is basically the past form of can. Okay, could is used to show the ability or capability or power to be used in the past time. Okay, let's read here. Could is the past tense of can. It is used to express ability or power in the past. Example, I could solve your problems. I could solve your problems. He could do his work neatly means we are talking about the past time ke main kar sakta tha, theek hai. He could do his work neatly, wo apna kaam acche se kar sakta tha. He could speak on various topics. He could win the race. So could is the past ability here. It's showing the past ability. Could is also used to express the polite request, offer in the present time. Okay, Now, could I see your pencil kit? Means I am asking, I am requesting to see the pencil kit in a polite way. I am questioning in a polite way. Could you go with him? Could I have your number? Could we go to the mall? Okay, so in a polite way we are requesting the other person. In such cases also we use could, but it is in the present time. Use of must. Now must word itself indicates necessity of something. Urgency means something is very urgent to be done. Must is used to express necessity. You must go there now means tumhe abhi jana chahiye. You must go to meet her. You must get some sleep. You must finish this work by 9. Means it's very important for you to finish your work by 9. So must here is the modal helping verb. Then must is used to express conclusion also. Okay. Suppose some incident has happened and a particular action was not completed. So just to give a reasoning for that, to justify that, what conclusions we use? She must be ready. She must be ready means usko ready hona chahiye. It is important for her. She must be ready ya wo ready ho gayi hogi. Theek hai? Then he must be in some difficulty. Ho sakta hai ke wo kisi mushkil mein fas gaya ho. Theek hai? To she must be ready. Hum ye guess kar rahe hain ke wo ready ho chuki hogi. Theek hai? Aur agar hum necessity ke liye use kare to hum aise baat karenge ke use ready ho jana chahiye. It is important. But yahan pe conclusion ke liye hai to hum ye baat kar rahe hain ke she must be ready, मतलब वो ready हो चुकी होगी, तो हम conclusion निकाल रहे हैं, ठीक है? He must be in some difficulty, maybe due to some reason, he must be facing some problem. Then next use of must is to, it is used to express prohibition. Prohibition means when something is prohibited, when something is not desired to happen. जिसके लिए आपको रोका जाए, ठीक है, कि ये चीज़ नहीं होनी चाहिए. यू मस्ट नॉट टच द इलेक्ट्रिकल वायर्स. तो ये प्रोहिबिशन होगी, मीन्स वी आर नॉट सपोज टू टच द इलेक्ट्रिकल वायर्स. तो उसको कैसे हमने बोलना है? मस्ट नॉट एम्फेसाइज करके, यू मस्ट नॉट टच द इलेक्ट्रिकल वायर्स. सो इन केस ऑफ प्रोहिबिशन वी नीड टू यूज मस्ट इन नेगेटिव वे विद द नॉट विद नेगेशन. You must not walk on the grass. You must not pluck flowers. Okay? So in all these three sentences, we are prohibiting the other person. We are just stopping the other persons to do some actions. Then next use of must is to express determination. Determination, when we have strong determination to do some action, ke hame karna hi karna hai. और ये ज़रूरी है. वी मस्ट विन द कॉम्पिटिशन दिस ईयर. हमें जीतना ही जीतना है. विद स्ट्रॉन्ग विल पावर वी आर सेइंग दिस. वी मस्ट डू वेल दिस ईयर. आई मस्ट लीव फॉर मुंबई टुमारो. ओके, सो विद स्ट्रॉन्ग डिटरमिनेशन आई एम सेइंग दैट आई मस्ट लीव फॉर मुंबई टुमारो. ऑलराइट, सो दीज आर द यूजेज ऑफ मस्ट. ओके, सो आई होप ऑल दीज मोडल हेल्पिंग वर्ब्स आर क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू. So just go through this video carefully. With this we have ended the chapter of verbs. So try to solve all these exercises which are given here, and you will be provided with the answer key also. So I'll get back to you soon with my next video. Till then, take care, bye bye, have a good day.